what is life? What is a beautiful life? It's nothing but what we think beautiful is. Yes, to lead a successful life, you should build your life, each and every moment of your life, with love, laughter, sacrifice, patience and forgiveness. So what should you love? Your passion, that is your ambition, your job. Keep a love upon your job. What should you be jealous of? Nothing. Do not be jealous of anything. What should you should be patient till you reach greater heights. What should you laugh at? The insults and mockeries that you face behind, and you should boast at how far I have grown in this contemporary competitive world. And what should you forgive? All the mishaps that you have created. What are the mistakes you have done in your life? What should you sacrifice? Nothing but your idle-mindedness. Sacrifice your idleness, brisk up in life, and life naturally becomes beautiful. We all have a passion towards reading and listening to. So, didn't we read anything all these years? No. Absolutely, we would have come across one of the greatest epics, the Mahabharata. And one incident I would like to quote from Mahabharata is that the hunting scene where Guru Dronacharya with his disciples in the forest, the princess will be standing in a line and Guru Dronacharya will ask a question pointing to a tree. He will ask, what do you see there in the tree? So each of the disciple gives a variety of answers. One says, I could see the complete tree. One says, I could see the branches. One says, I could see a beautiful parrot in it. One says that I could see the heaps and the plumpy fruits in it. And one unique, peculiar character, Arjuna, he would say that I could see only the one-sided eye of the parrot. At once Drona said, come on Arjuna, shoot up your arrow. So that is success. You may run up in this competitive world like anything. So as far as competitive exams are concerned, people travel from various district to districts and they start preparing for the exams, and when they get low marks or they descend from their ranks, they start get depressed of their situation. Why should it be so? You have hidden skills and talents in you. So this was discussed in the last 3 days. You have skill. You should bring your skill out. How to bring your skill? You have capability. And this capability could be brought out only when you have passion. And what are the steps to lead a successful life? How could you become a better career project manager? So all these were discussed in the previous day sessions. And I give you all a cordial welcome to the fourth day of this training program on career guidance and counseling for competitive examinations. I must quote here about the life of my great inspiration, one of the greatest Tamil poets, Subramania Bharathiar. We all know him as a renowned patriotic poet. But once, while he was studying, there was a competition on verse writing where Bharati won the third place. People, we always stick on to the ranks what we score. if we get second or third rank, we pull ourselves down and we start murmuring, sitting at one corner place. So Bharati did not fed up with this situation. He continued his writing, and today we are reminded and we always utter the name of only Subramanya Bharatiya, and we do not know the names of the other two prize winners who came the first and the second position. So that is life. Why do you think of going on the same path of competitive examinations? Are we rails to follow the same platform? No. We are, after all, just human beings. Each human being have his own destiny to be followed up. Yeah. This day focuses on such a platform, creative writing and journalism. So why I talked about Subramanya Bharati is that he is a creative writer and a journalist too. He is a freelance journalist. At once, while discussing about the topics for the future days, and we landed upon this particular topic, creative writing and journalism, I am reminded of none but this girl, Miss V. Archana, Assistant Professor of English, Parvati's Arts and Science College, Dindigul. So for all these three days, I have been speaking proud about my own professors and my own friend. And today, I feel extremely much delighted to speak about my student. So, like Dronacharya, I feel blessed to have my student as one of the resourceful alumni for this training program. Creative writing gave her a good platform. She is one of the rank holders again in the batch 2013-16. She did her PG in Stella Maris College, Chennai, and she was a rank holder there too in her PG. At once she completed her postgraduate, she went for coaching for NET examinations to Kerala. She stayed there and she successfully got through her NET examinations clear in December 2019. So creative writing, the very first publication she made, she said, texted me a message, "Madam, I got my first book published in Dharmic Publishers." So I was really overwhelmed, and I thought she would be the best person to talk for this day's topic. So with all these simple few words, I'd like to extend a sincere gratitude to our Madam Principal Dr. N. Puveneshwari for giving me such a great opportunity to proceed into such a great program. I think it's really a great boon for me, for such a great personality to travel with me in these days. Secondly, I would never fail to acknowledge the head of the department, EGM Research Department of English, Madam Mrs. P. Selby, who threw seeds, poured water, manure, and grew the crops. I was just a supervisor for these crops. So she was the one who gave me such good idea for this program. And I thank you, Madam. And I should say about these resourceful alumni. So after fixing all these persons in mind, and while I started contacting them, the very first thing they reported me is, "Yes, I will do it." So thank you, my dear resource persons, Dr. S. Kailvili Madam, Madam Dr. S. Kalevani, Madam Mrs. R. Lakshmi, and Madam Miss Archana, for giving their consent to carry on with this program successfully for all these 4 days. Last but not the least, I thank you all, my dear participants. Big success of this program is none but you. You gave me hands in this program, and With the help of you all, I've reached the success of this program. Once again, a big thanks to all.
Hi, hello everyone. I'm B. Archana, MA English, NET. I worked in Parvati's Arts and Science College. I did my PG MA English at Stella Maris College. I did my UG BA English at Arulmigu Palniyandava Arts College for Women from 2013 to 2016. I also cleared National Eligibility Test in December 2019. First, I would like to thank the college for giving me this opportunity, and my special thanks to the head of the department and especially Katyayani ma'am, who wanted me to talk today. And I would like to discuss a few topics with you, like how to prepare for competitive examinations and also about career guidance. To achieve success in life, you have to follow few things. Be motivated, be confident, be determined, fix your goal. I have to tell you a good short story, which most of us are familiar. You know Abraham Lincoln, right? Who's he? The former president of USA. He failed 42 years in his life. His mom died. He failed in the elections many times, and he was elected as the 16th president of USA. So failure is the stepping stone to success. That is true in case of Abraham Lincoln, because 42 years of failure is not an easy thing. You have to endure the pain. You have to endure the failure. Failure doesn't end the life. It's the beginning. He doesn't stop with his failure. He worked on it. And he was selected as the president of USA. That is not an easy thing, right? Being a president of USA, he actually freed 35 lakh slaves. He was a great leader. Leadership was there, right? And you have to have a ambition. You have to be ambitious with an ambition. So first, find what is your goal, work on it, right? As everyone says, whatever, so if you open YouTube and just look through some motivation videos, everything, every video, they used to tell, wake up early. Okay, that is not my cup of tea, really. No, I don't wake up early. I usually use my night time to study, but still that is really an important point. Waking up early is a good habit. It gives you healthy mind and healthy body. Self-motivation is very important. You are your own motivator. You are your own positive speaker. So no one is going to eat instead of you. If you are hungry, you have to eat. Okay. Life without ambition is a failure. So you should have an ambition. Ask questions. If you have any doubt or anything, who's senior to you or who will be helpful to your teachers, definitely. Just approach them, ask questions to them. They will really help you. Make reading your habit, not only for literature students. I'm telling to everyone, reading is a very good habit which teaches you life. I learned life from reading. Okay, reading a lot of books. I love reading books, and I have a lot of books in my home. I used to buy books. Whenever I have money, I'll not buy anything. I'll just buy books. So that much crush I have on books. So first, it is because of this one book. This one book which I read during my 10th standard is Boys and Girls Be Ambitious by Dr. C. Sailendra Babu. In this book, he discusses about PQRST method of learning. P for preview. Preview is whatever you learn, just read it again and get the important points. Then question. You have to question on the topic which you're reading. You should have doubts. Without doubts, nothing is cleared. Okay, you have to ask doubts to your teachers. You have to question yourself. What did you understand from this? What did you learn from this? How can you apply it in your life? That is question. Then R for read. Reading is a very important habit. Find some time to read in any book. It may not be only in English. You can read Tamil books also. Okay, reading is very important. Please, for those who are, I want to tell you, for those who wanted to speak English fluently, please read Hindu newspaper. Hindu newspaper really helps you to improve your vocabulary. Especially for those who are preparing for IBPS and UPSC, you definitely have to read the Hindu. Especially the editorial page and the perspective page, which is next to their editorial page. So give importance to reading. Reading is very important. S for self-recital. So after studying anything, you just recite to yourself or recite to someone, discuss it with someone. Just study with your friends. That is self-recital. T for test. Yeah, very important. You have to look on the previous question papers and test yourself whether you have learned it fully. So you, with this method of learning, I think you can definitely clear your any competitive exams. He has given a short stories about, even Abraham Lincoln's story is from this book I told you. There are small short stories which is very motivating. Surround yourself with people who motivate you. Just ignore those who discourage you. Just ignore negativity, right? And I wanted to tell you, be determined, don't procrastinate. So you can do it tomorrow. You need not do it tomorrow. You have to do it today. Make it compulsory. Make a schedule, make a plan. Planning is very important. Whatever exams you're preparing for, make a plan, make a schedule, and make sure that you follow the schedule and do it properly, right? The important thing that you have to do for preparing for competitive exams is sacrifice. You have to do a lot of sacrifice. Getting addicted to your mobile phones or TV or being lazy is, with this you can't achieve. You have to sacrifice few things. Okay, without working hard, nothing is possible. Working hard, you have to study. I'm not telling you to study the whole day. I'm not telling you to only study every time. You just use your time to spend it with your friends and family. You can go sometime out, not during this corona time. I'm just telling generally. You can just go out, have some fresh air. It's not easy to sit for hours and study, right? You can study for half an hour, take 5 minutes break and then come back, study for half an hour. So make it a habit for any exam, not only for the competitive exam, for your semester exam also. You have to study. You can't sit in a whole day and prepare for any exams. You need some rest. So I just wanted to tell about something that which happened in my life, which changed my life. Reading changed my life, actually. This is the first book I read after Sailendra Babu's book. This is Life is What You Make It. So even the title is very positive. She was the first reader I read, and she's my inspiration till now. She chats with me on Instagram. This book tells you what life is all about, how you can cope up with the failures, how you can endure them, and how you can come up in life. Its sequel is this, Wake Up, Life is Calling. It's a very good book, you can read. Prepare for any competitive exams. You must have determination. You must have ambition. You have to work through the goal which you have fixed. Don't stop with this. Don't procrastinate things. That is a very bad thing. Procrastination is not your cup of tea. Hard work is very important. So whatever competitive exam you are preparing for, just just work for it. Right, you'll definitely achieve it. And I wanted to discuss on career options. So career options after completing your degree, your PG or UG, whatever it might be, there are different career options that you can go for. Whatever major you are pursuing, first thing is you have to do is you have to love your subject. Love whatever you're doing. You can do master's on it. If you're doing your PG on any concerned subject, you can do masters on it, and further you can carry out what to do. You can think what goal you have. First you have to identify your own dream, like you have to identify your own ambition, what interest you have. Identify your interest and work on it. So there are few career options that I wanted to discuss, like as I said, master in your same stream, whatever you're studying, whatever subject you're studying, you can do PG on it. Or you can do an MBA. MBA is business administration. That will help you to do a business. You can become an entrepreneur, and you can build on it. Like you can become a businessman or businesswoman, right? Not a businessman. then you or else you can pursue law. Law, if you are interested, if you are a good speaker, you can definitely pursue law. Then investment banking is there. Banking is there. You can prepare for IBPS and you can definitely clear it. UPSC, yeah, anyone can prepare for UPSC, but that needs patience, patient. But you need to be calm and patient to pursue your UPSC, right? As I said, banking, you will get high pay for that. Then you can do hotel management. Hotel management is one of the options. Designing is there. You can work in an IT company, or else you can be a event manager. So yeah, many. But due to Corona, nothing is happening. But still, if after Corona, this situation is not going to be the same, right? So after Corona, if any functions there, you can be an event manager. Event management, you can be pursuing event management. Or you can, for English and Tamil students, you can go for drama and theater. You can be a theater person, you can act. And choreography. If you're interested in dancing, you can be a choreographer. Or if you are a sports person, you have to find which sports you are mastering in. And you can find a good coach for it and you can go for it. Or you can be yourself become a good coach. Right? Fitness is very important nowadays. You can start a gym, but that's for mostly, it need not be only for boys. So I have seen many girls who are doing fitness advice on Instagram. You can do that. Or you can become a beautician. Beautician is also a good career option. And YouTuber, you can become a YouTuber. See, like if I'm giving you a lecture, video lecture, if I can post this in YouTube and I can create a channel, make a channel on it. So you can become a YouTuber. Content writer. So those who are studying literature, that is English, you can become a content writer. You can become for there are many career options for literature students, English literature students, not only literature students, but especially for them. Content writer, you can become a screenwriter, you can become a songwriter in English. For other students, for other major students, you can also become a script writer, you can also become a screenwriter, you can become a director, you can become a songwriter, you can also become a web content writer, and you can become a blogger, you can also become a video game writer. You can write video games if you're interested in that. You can become a poet, you can become a columnist. Columnist is nothing you write in a newspaper. Columnist. Creative writing instructor. You can become a creative writing instructor. Legacy writer. You can become a critic or reviewer. You can review things. You can just read some books and give reviews on it. You can learn from it, right? You can become a blogger is very important now. Blogger is trending nowadays because everyone is at home and they are writing blogs. Greeting card author. You can become a journalist. Journalism has a very good future, right? You can become a news reader. You can become a reporter. Not only in English, for Tamil also. If you're fluent in Tamil, you can definitely become a news reader in any of the Tamil channels because nowadays 24 hours news service is there. You can become a copywriter. You can become a novelist if you're interested. If you are much interested in creative writing, you can become a novelist. You can become a writing coach. Or you can start a freelancing. You can become a short story writer or an article writer, right? I wanted to discuss on creative writing. Yeah. So whatever I did, I will tell you because to become a lecturer, you have to write many journals, you have to publish many things. So creative writing is very important. Okay. Not only to become a lecturer, generally you can have a knowledge of creative writing which will help you to earn. Okay, you can become a freelance writer. So firstly, creative writing is nothing but you have to have a creative writing is nothing but you have to have a general knowledge, like fictional knowledge. You have to have an imaginative knowledge. Like she's Preeti Sharma. Let me see her picture. So you can follow her on Instagram, Facebook. She's in both. She also have a website, preetishenoy.com. You can follow on her. She is a blogger. She writes blog and she gives important topics on creative writing, which was really helpful for me. And I actually follow her. She's my inspiration, as I said earlier. I met her once in Coimbatore and we were discussing about things. She gave advice that how to start writing a fiction. You have to begin with a short story and then build on it and become it and make it into a fiction, right? Something that should be avoided in creative writing is don't use fillers. You have to bring it the story. It's not like you can use fillers and make it big. That will not happen in creative writing. Okay, just avoid the fillers. Write only which is important. Okay, you have to check the grammar and spelling mistakes. So to improve your vocabulary, you definitely have to read books, right? Creative writing has a very good scope because it has a good value in the market. Creative writing. So let us look into creative writing. What is creative writing and what are the barriers for writing? And also we'll see what scope we have for creative writing and also few criteria on creative writing. Okay, so first, creative writing. What is creative writing? Creative, just take the word creative writing. Creativity. So you have to have you must have the knowledge of writing with imagination. You should have an innovative knowledge. So that is all about it. Any writing can be creative writing rather than journalistic or academic writing. That is totally different. So creative writing, I'll read a definition. Just listen to it carefully. Any writing that goes outside the bounds of normal, professional, journalistic, academic or technical forms of literature. As I said earlier, so any writing can be a creative writing, but with innovative knowledge. It should not be a usual writing. You should think differently. Your work must be unique when compared to the others. It's not every writer's write the same thing. No, that is not creative writing. You should employ new techniques. You should follow new tropes to write creative writing. So it is a narrative craft. Okay, it's like a craft. It will be very innovative and new, right? Craft is something which is very interesting. Similar to that, creative writing is also interesting. Then it might be fictional or non-fictional. It may not only be fictional, it can either be fictional or non-fictional. So what comes under creative writing? Autobiography. Autobiography is writing about yourself. Biography, let it be biography, which tells about any important personalities. Then creative non-fiction, it is personal diary or journalistic writing. My journalistic essays, not writing, journalism is different. Essays comes under creative writing. And children's books, you can write. Drama is there, epic, graphic novels, comics. So those who are doing fine arts, you can draw pictures, you can become a cartoonist in journalism. That is a different, totally different topic. You can also become a comic writer and also novel. Novella is a short novel. Play, you can write. Poetry is there. Screenplay, you can write screenplay for movies and short stories. You can be a dialogue writer and you can also be a blogger. I'll tell what blog is at the end. So for creative writing, you must have a very creative knowledge. As I said earlier, it should have an emotional impact on the readers. It should be with some theme. It should be with some moral message. Then only it will impact the readers, or else readers will not find it interesting. Okay, here are few tropes that I want to discuss. Few criteria that I wanted to discuss with you. See, three criteria is there. First is, you should have the knowledge, like you should remember what you have experienced. So you can bring in your own life experiences in creative writing. So that is the first criteria. Second one is you are sharing your thoughts, your experience, and your story with an interested group. So only a selective people will be reading you. So you must be ready to share anything with them. Okay, it might be autotelic. And the third one is free individual expression. So you can express your mental or physical stress through writing. This is a very good idea to express through writing. So you must have you must be frank. You must be open to share your information to others. Right? So fine arts students, you really have a good scope in creative writing. And I wanted to discuss about the elements of creative writing. So what are the elements of creative writing? We'll see. First point is unique plot. There must be a unique plot if you are writing any piece of literature, any piece of work. Okay, so the plot must not be similar to other writing. It must be your original product. There is no plagiarism in creative writing. It is your own product of writing. And character development is important. Okay, you should build a strong protagonist of the story so that the readers doesn't get bored. Okay, they should understand, they should feel same with the protagonist. So that is very important in creative writing. And there must be there must be an underlying theme or message. There really must be a moral in the story. So you have to teach lessons through your stories. Okay, or something which have happened in your previous past life, you can tell them that this should not happen again. So there must be a moral. Then there must be a visual description. This is very, very important in creative writing. So when you just cannot write any piece of work without describing what are the things around you, right? So visual description. So when the reader reads the piece of work, they should actually understand what is happening. So okay, if you are describing about a bedroom or a living room, you should detail the things which are present in the room, right? If there is a bed, the bedspread is with flowers, something like that. That is very important, visual description. The reader must imagine what you are thinking in your mind. Okay, they should get the author's point of view. Then first person narrative, that is the main character, is very important in the novel or any short story or poetry, whatever it might be. Then dialogue is important to support the story. You need not bring every dialogues in the story, but to make it interesting, you have to bring in dialogues spoke by the characters in the work. Then imaginative language should be there. You can use figures of speech. There must be alliteration, simile, there must be comparison. So it will be interesting for the readers. Then emotional appeal. This also I said earlier, you must definitely have an emotional impact on the readers. They should feel pity. So the readers must have an emotional appeal. So these are the elements of creative writing. Moving on to a few exercises that would help you to write better. So we'll see what are they. So first thing you have to do is you have to write a diary, a personal diary, kind of personal diary, that is with imagination. Okay, write whatever happens from the morning in the diary with some imagination. You can add some hyper real things, so which improves your creative thinking. Then second thing which you should do is description depiction, as I said, the visual description. That you can imagine, for example, you can imagine any person in your mind, maybe your friend or your teacher or your any of your relative. You can just think about them, and once you might have visited their house, so just describe the things in their house. So that might help, right? So that is the description depiction. Third one is edit your old writing. So if you have written anything earlier, just edit it. Editing will really help. Okay, check for grammar, spelling mistakes, and improve, build on your writing. As I said earlier, reading is very important. The one thing which you can build up on your language is especially from your reading. Okay, please read and learn vocabularies. That is very important thing. Then third, edit your old writing. Yes. Then moving on to voice variations. So voice variations is very important. So if you are writing any character, their character must reveal what kind of person they are to the readers. So if the person is a drunkard, might be an emotional person or a person who is very angry, so that you should experience with the dialogue. Okay. So the voice variations, the readers must able to understand the voice variations while they're reading the dialogue. So that is important. Then dialogue destruction. I told dialogue is very important, but you need not use many dialogues. So try to avoid each and every detail. Okay, if she comes and tells like this, no, she comes and said that, you can just write like that, you in a continuous thing. You need not bring dialogue for every line. There must be paragraphs and also dialogues that will make interesting. Then the readers should understand what you are coming to tell. Okay, what you are about to tell. And next thing is, this is an interesting thing that you can, that everyone can do. Just start doing it from today. Rewrite the stories which you know earlier, which you heard earlier, or which you read earlier. Even the fairy tales which you have read in your small age, during your KG classes or during the primary school. You can just rewrite the stories, build in your imagination, bring in your imagination. Okay, write it again. So read it for yourself. It will really help. And theme is important. And every point which I'm telling is theme. Theme is very important. There must be a moral message. Understand? So why the reader should read your work, right? There must be some message in the work. So that is important. Then break the language barriers. Very, very important for creative writing. You should break the language barriers. You should not feel, you should not hesitate to bring in your points. You can use a few words from your mother tongue, that doesn't matter, but still you should not make more mistakes. Okay, build on your language. Then for example, I'll tell you this. You can simply tell it is night. Okay. But in creative writing, you should not tell like that. Look, I have written one line. The beautiful black curtain decorated with shiny white flowers. So what is this? This is the description of night, right? You should not tell it directly. Your language must be pleasant, beautiful and impressive. Okay. Last thing is, I told you, use your mother tongue to get great impact. If you are writing, if you are listening to some song, you can bring in the lyrics in your own language. You need not translate it, right? You are hearing this song, you can bring it in quotes. If you are writing about yourself, I'm telling. Okay, editing and publishing. You edit for yourself, but that is not enough, right? Give it to your teacher or friends who is better than you in language, and find some publisher. Okay, I want to tell about my book which I published. I published two short stories, right? I have told you. I have a friend who was really helpful for me, helped me in publishing, Damick Publishers, New Delhi. You can approach them. Damick, husband and wife are having the publishing house. They both are writers. They'll really help you. They help me in publishing those two books. They conduct contest every year, I think more than 4 or 5 times in a year. You can participate in that contest and start building up your language. You can start from small short stories or poems by publishing, right? Yeah, so the scope for creative writing. There is a course, there is diploma course on creative writing, or else you have a certificate course. Okay, diploma course begins from 1 to 4 years, minimum of 1 year, but maximum you can do till 4 years. And you also have certificate course, which is from 2 to 4 weeks or a month. It based on the course, based on the institution they are doing. You can just Google it and you will find where they are teaching courses on certificate courses. There you can do it, right? So you can Google it and find the places where they are conducting the course, and anyone can do the course. right? What is the scope? Is you can become a creative writer, you can publish any of literary work, you can become a content writer. What a content writer is? Content writer is a business platform. You can earn a lot of money by writing reviews on your products or to write a content to sell your products, right? A few MNC companies are providing good salary for content writing. And fiction writer, as I said, you can become a novelist and proofreader. Proofreading is very, very important, like in newspaper also it might be. You have to have a strong knowledge on what language you are editing. Proofreading is nothing but editing. Okay, they'll give you a work, piece of work. You have to read it and you have to edit it. For that, you have to have a strong knowledge on the language, grammar and punctuations. Right? Blogger, blogging. What is a blog first? Blog is a piece of writing. It might be article or anything. Okay. Which you publish in a website or a web page. It is an online journal, kind of online journal. It might be in a informal conversational style. What is the purpose of blogging is? It is for personal use. It can also be for business use. You can write blogs to sell your products, and it is to connect with the target audience. Okay. Yeah, journalism. So what is journalism? Journalism is the production and distribution of events which is happening in the present and also in the past. Electronic media is there and also print media is there. Two types of media is there. Okay, it is a very good occupation. You will get a huge pay for this job offer, job career. And 24 hours news service is there, so you can join in any of the news channels or any of the newspaper company like Hindu. You'll have a great future. So we'll see a few things about journalism, scope for journalism and how to become a journalist, and what subject you have to do, what course you have to do to become a good journalist. Okay, first published journal was I'll just tell you, Acta Diurna. That was published in 59 BC. That is the first journal published. New sheet. It was in a kind of sheet. Ancient Rome. In ancient Rome, they have published this. So that is the first thing they published. In that news sheet, they circulated important public speeches that happened during their period. Okay. The first English newspaper was the Weekly News. The Weekly News, it was during 1622. Then firstly daily first daily newspaper was the Daily Current. Current is C-U-R-R-E-N-T. No, that is that not that current. C-O-U-R-A-N-T. Current. The Daily Current. Okay. In 1702. Then during the 20th century, journalism became a trend. It's a kind of trend because people are interested in social services and what are happening in the society. They are so much wanted to hear more about gossips and what are happening around the world. So during the 20th century, it became very popular. It became a profession during that time. Okay, many people started to work in journalistic field. So we'll see what are the important factors of journalism. Okay, why journalism became a trend? We'll see that. Due to increasing organization of working, many people started to work as a journalist, work as a reporter or a news reader or someone who works in journal mass media, right? Then specialized education. So education became very popular during the 20th century for journalism. We have a separate course for journalism. I'll tell you later. So then the people are interested in the problems which are happening around them, as I told, the problems and techniques of mass communication, they started learning journalism. Then social responsibility, fourth point, as I said, social responsibility started increasing. So what is the educational qualification to become a journalist? BA journalism and mass communication, MA journalism, and you can also do PhD in that. Okay, so what are the career options in the print media? We'll see what are the career options you have if you study journalism. First, you can become a reporter of the newspaper or magazine or radio or television, anything you can be. you must have a accurate knowledge on what news you are reporting, right? You have to have a knowledge to distinguish the story, and you have to tell what you have understood from that, and you have to tell the real thing, the real incident that happened around you. Okay, that is very important. The objectivity you should know. To tell it very precise, you should have a knowledge of that. Then you can become a special reporter, correspondent or a special reporter. For that, you should have a knowledge in a particular field, like politics or sports. You should have a general knowledge about that, right? And you should have a special ability to read the lines and explain it, what of your understanding, what you understand, you have to explain it. That is the special reporter. And future writer. What is a future writer? You should have the capability to write in-depth stories. You have to explain the incident. You cannot just simply leave it by telling what the news is all about. You have to explain about it. That is important. Then you also can become a lead writer, that is leader writer. This is for people who write in editorial column. You can choose one topic and you have to discuss about that. That is the leader writer. Then proofreader, as I said, it's similar to editing. You have to check edits. You must have a sharp knowledge on that. Edit and write on, not write. You have to correct the mistakes. That is proofreader. Editor, proofreader is different to editor. You have to become a proofreader, you have to edit. That is, you have to evaluate, compare, and the news should not be repeated again. Okay. That is proof reader. Editor is the key head. This is the final thing which you do in newspaper. Editor, after writing all the news, editor must check everything. Even small mistakes, he have to correct it. And he must bring the newspaper very catchy. When the reader buys it, it should be very catchy. He is responsible for that. Editor is very, very much responsible. So he is the key head. Okay. So there must be a uniformity and continuity that he should make sure of it. Editor should make sure of it. She should make sure of it. Sorry. And columnist. So columnist is one who writes something in a particular subject, particular topic must be there. Okay. Like fashion or politics, one general topic in a specialized field, they should know everything about that topic. If fashion, you have to build up your knowledge on fashion to become a columnist. Okay, then critique. To become a critique, you definitely have to know each and every details. You just can't simply go and write some critical review on anything. Okay, so there must be a comprehensive knowledge of the subject which is concerned. Then photojournalist, this is such a risk, such a difficult job to do, because clicking photos is not an easy task. You must be fast to do that, and you should have a creative knowledge, like how if the photo is clicked, will it reach the audience who are reading it, right? So willing to work in any difficult condition, this is one important thing to become a photojournalist. Then you must also be able to write catchy headlines. Okay. Technical knowledge should also be there. Cartoonist. Coming to cartoonist, for fine art students, you can become a cartoonist. You must have an artistic and a humoristic knowledge. You must be able to criticize politics or anything, any topic, in a humoristic way. You should it is also a difficult topic, because criticizing or satirizing political people is not an easy thing, right? You might get into trouble, so you might be able to work in such hard, difficult situation, but still you have to do it in a humoristic way without hurting others, right? In a satirical manner. Then in electronic media, what you can become is, you can become a researcher. You have to go become a research on what news you are going to report. It must be clear, because news media, many people work in that, many will help. In electronic media, if you are a blogger or if you're a blogger, definitely you are the one who are doing the research on the news. So you have to work on it. You have to go to the site and give the correct news. In journalism, fake news doesn't help you. it will really put you in trouble. Okay, broadcast reporter. You can become a broadcast reporter. You can read news. You must have a good communication skills. Then presenter also saying you must have a good communication skill and command over comprehension over speech. So diction, language, GK, you must possess intelligence. You should have to work in a stressful condition. Then you must, this is very important to become a reporter or a news reader. So you must have a good smiling face all the time. You if someone if you're taking any interview, if someone hurts you, you should not show that angry in your face. Okay, you must always be appealing, right? Okay, you'll get a good salary for journalism, and I'll tell you few points to become a good journalist, right? So first you have to study journalism, UG BA journalism. Then if you want, you can study MA journalism, complete an internship, choose a good area. First you have to choose, if you are interested in politics, definitely you have to know what, everything about politics, who are the leaders and who are the important ministers, so something like that, you should definitely have a knowledge about that. So okay, if you are writing on business, you should have a good business knowledge. Then for photojournalist, I told what are the tropes for that, you should build upon it. To become a sports person, you have to know everything about sports. Science or health, you should have a sound knowledge on science and health. So there are many fresher jobs, you can Google it and find. In everything, as I said, everything is in your doorstep, you just have to Google it. Then if you want, you can build on your education, you can do your PhD on journalism. Then how to write a report, this is very important, right? How to become a good reporter, how to write a report. So first thing you should do is collect information about the news. We'll see. So first you have to figure out what to write, that is what you should be clear about the news. Go to the scene, if any crime scene is there, you can go to the scene and find what are the information you can collect. Then conduct interview with people. So when people are around, if some accident or anything happens, just go there, ask the people around there. You should get correct knowledge from them. There is no fake news, right? You should get the exact news. Then you have to, whatever you have took notes or you have interviewed people, you have to transcribe it into dialogues or speeches. Then do research on it. So how to write it, how to build up the essay, that is the news, the true news. Then first thing is you have to write a catchy headline. Headline is very important. Then byline and place. Byline is your name and place line is where this happened. Then opening paragraph is very important in a report, because you should not simply give the introduction and leave it. The whole news must be summarized in the first paragraph, where it happened, how it happened, who was the reason, so when, what, how, all WH questions should be answered in the first paragraph, because the reader might not have time to read your news. So few people will be there by stopping in the first paragraph, right? So it is a technique to cover the readers. Then you have to write the body of the report, you have to explain everything what happened, and you can include quotes or dialogues. Then speak in past tense, this is very important. You should write the report in past tense. Okay, if you are writing any new para, you should start in a new thought, you should start in a new paragraph. Yes, I covered everything, I guess. I covered everything on creative writing and also journalism. Hope you'll follow the same. I think it was useful for you. All the best. Do well. Study well. Never stop your hard work. Work hard and you'll achieve what you dreamt. Right? Bye. Take care. I tried my best to bring all the points together. I don't know how did I do this session, but thank you for giving me this opportunity. Stay home, stay safe. Bye.